Hey fam, welcome back to my channel. As always, my name is Joy. Now, this weekend, I really, really had this strong desire to just kind of go on a sabbatical where I, on Saturday, I kind of just locked myself in and just really spent time with God. And I just remember being in my prayer closet and just like spending that time with God. And I just really heard him asking me, are you really ready? Like, are you really ready? And for a moment, I was like, God, ready for what? Right? I'm like, what you mean, God? Am I ready? Ready for what? Like, why are we having these discussions, God? Right? But he was like, are you really ready for the promise? Are you really ready? And I sat there for a moment and I got so overwhelmed with emotion. And I just remember crying and just saying, yes, like, yes, I'm ready, God. Like, yes, I'm ready. And I just started having like flashbacks of the last year and everything that God has done in my life, like how he's changed me, how he has matured me, how he has transformed me, right? And then all of a sudden, I heard God just say, I am moving swiftly. I am moving swiftly. And he was like, I was like, okay, God, you know, like, all right, cool. And I just heard God just saying, I want you to look up swiftly. I want you to look up the word swiftly. So I did. And when I looked it up, it said, at high speed, quickly, without delay, after a very short time. And I remember saying, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. I know you're moving swiftly pertaining to my promise. And then he took me to Isaiah 60, verse 22. And I heard him saying, the least of you will become a thousand, the smallest a mighty nation. I am the Lord. In its time, I will do it swiftly. My brothers and my sister, we are at a time where God is establishing kingdom marriages. This is the time for kingdom marriages. I posted a few videos and I said, God said, it is done. Pertaining to your marriage, it is done. This is the time God is establishing kingdom marriages. Right? And in Isaiah 60, 22, God is saying, the least of you will become a thousand, the smallest a mighty nation. I am the Lord. In its time, I will do this swiftly. This is the time that God is establishing kingdom marriages. And God is saying that because this is the time, he is establishing them swiftly. The story that God started downloading into me, and I had never seen these things before, or maybe I had just overlooked them. He took me to the book of Ruth, and I love the book of Ruth because the book of Ruth reads like a novel to me. And I don't know about y'all, but I love romance novels, right? So he took me to the book of Ruth and we went through chapter 3 and chapter 4. And in chapter 3, Naomi, who was bitter, Naomi, who had lost everything, Naomi, who was back at her hometown, was giving Ruth, her daughter-in-law, instructions on what to do. She was Ruth's divine connection. And she was instructing her, this is what you need to do when you go to the threshing floor. This is what you need to do. Just like Holy Spirit has been giving you instructions. Just like Holy Spirit has been telling you, this is how you need to move. Naomi was giving Ruth instructions, right? And in chapter 3, we see Ruth following all those instructions to the T. She does everything that she is instructed to do. Once the party is over, she goes and she lays at the feet of Boaz. And when Boaz wakes up in the middle of the night, sees this woman, he asks her, "Who are you? Who are you?" And she responds exactly how Naomi had told her to respond. And this man does not touch her, a man of honor, but rather he says, "I am going to cover you. I am going to ensure that when the morning comes, I do what's right to make sure that I redeem you, that I redeem Naomi, that I redeem your bloodline," right? That I redeem you, right? So Ruth goes home, right? And when she goes home, she tells her mother-in-law everything that happened. And Naomi tells her, "I want you to see how fast God is moving." So this is Ruth 3, verse 18. "Then Naomi said, 'Wait, my daughter, until you find out what happens. For the man will not rest until the matter is settled today.'" Today, not tomorrow, but today. Right? I had never seen that. I had never noticed that. Right? And when we move on to chapter 4, it says, "Meanwhile." Now, mind you, Ruth woke up in the morning. She left before anybody could see her because Boaz did not want anybody to be talking about this woman, a man of honor. Can we say that? Right? She goes home, tells her mother-in-law everything. That her mother-in-law says, "That man would not rest until he sees that something happens today, until he settles it today," right? So Boaz then goes out to the town gate and goes to talk to the main guy who was actually supposed to be Ruth's guardian redeemer, waits for him, presents his case to that man and to the elders of the town, right? And the man ultimately says, "Hey, I don't want to redeem Ruth. I don't want to redeem Naomi. You go ahead and do it," because Boaz was next in line. If you have not read this story, I encourage you to read this story because this is just such an amazing story, right? So they have their discussion and Boaz gets the blessings to go ahead and redeem Naomi and take Ruth as his wife, right? So the verse that I'm going to be reading is Ruth 4, 13, and I'm also gonna read 22. "So Boaz took Ruth and she became his wife. When he made love to her, the Lord enabled her to conceive and gave birth to a son. Obed, the father of Jesse, and Jesse, the father of David." Let me tell you how quickly it moved. Boaz got the blessings to go ahead and marry Ruth. He went ahead and made her his wife. Got to know her intimately. She got pregnant. She gives birth to a son named Obed. Obed is the father of Jesse. Jesse is the father of David. David was the father of Solomon, a mighty and great king, a wise king. And we know from the bloodline of David is where our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ comes from. So when the Lord is saying that he is about to make your small nation a mighty nation, he is not playing. And the Lord was asking me, "Are you ready?" Because the Lord is moving swiftly. Let me tell you, my brothers and my sisters, you are going to be asking for permission today, and the next morning, you're going to be getting joined to your spouse. And a day later, you're going to find out that you have already conceived. And then guess what? In 9 months, you're giving birth to a great and mighty nation. The Lord is moving swiftly. So what the Lord is asking, are you really ready? I'm not talking about, is your wedding gown ready? I'm not talking about, Are your shoes ready? I'm not talking about is the ring ready, but are you ready for this ministry? Are you ready for what your marriage is about to bring? Are you ready for the nation that's about to be birthed from your marriage? That is what the Lord is asking. Are you ready? Are you ready? Because in this time, in this season, God is moving swiftly. God doesn't have time for you to be preparing. You were supposed to do that while you were in the jungle. You're supposed to be ready mentally. You're supposed to be ready physically, emotionally, and spiritually. God is asking, are you really ready? Because when I told the Lord, yes, I am, I'm ready, He gave me Isaiah 60:22. And He said He is moving swiftly. He said He is moving swiftly. The least of you will become 1,000. The smallest, a mighty nation. I am the Lord. In its time, I will do it swiftly. My brothers and my sisters, we are in the time where God is establishing kingdom marriages. He is doing it swiftly. From Ruth, a Moabite woman, a foreign woman, God birthed a nation. Ruth started a lineage where our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ came from. Do you hear me? The tiniest nation is about to become mighty. Are you ready? I don't mean is your dress ready. I don't mean is are your shoes ready? Is the ring ready? That's not what I mean. That's what the wilderness was for. That's what the Holy Spirit has been communicating to you. That's what Holy Spirit, who is your Naomi, has been telling you. Get ready to move. Get your dress ready. Get the venue ready. Get all these things ready. Now God is asking you, are you really ready? Because you are about to step into ministry. Your marriage is a ministry. Your marriage is going to change the world. 2 by 2, He sent them out. 2 by 2, He sent them out. That's what God is doing. We are in the end times. And marriage was God's first ministry. So He is reestablishing this first ministry so He can send us out 2 by 2. Because it may seem like the Lord is slow to act in coming back. But the Lord is very merciful. The Lord is very faithful. The Lord is establishing these marriages because He's about to send people out 2 by 2 to go and win back souls for the kingdom. God doesn't want you to perish. God wants you to be saved. The time is now. The time is now. Are you ready? Because God is moving swiftly. As always, He loves you. I love you. Be blessed.